So thank you so much for being part of this. We are going to look at the Bernoulli's principle. And before you look at the Bernoulli's principle, remember that we have the Bernoulli's effect. So the Bernoulli's effect usually gives us the three assumptions for a fluid through the tube of flow, that it states that the Bernoulli's effect states that provided the fluid is non-viscous, incompressible, and its flow is streamlined. An increase in velocity. An increase in velocity causes a corresponding decrease in pressure. So that is the Bernoulli's effect, which says that provided the fluid is non-viscous, incompressible, and its flow is streamlined, an increase in velocity causes a corresponding decrease in pressure. Therefore, from the Bernoulli's effect, we get the three assumptions that the fluid should be non-viscous, it should be incompressible, and the flow should be streamlined. Another name for streamlined flow is the steady flow. Then, increasing velocity will cause a decrease in pressure. So these are the keywords when setting the Bernoulli's effect. Therefore, if I take you back to the Bernoulli's principle, number one, I want us to look at the kinetic energy, Ke. The kinetic energy is calculated by the value of 1/2 mv². Then we also have the potential energy, which is calculated by the value of 1/2. The potential energy is the energy possessed by the particle at rest, which is calculated by mgh. And therefore, for you to calculate volume, that is for measurement one, volume is given by mass over density. For you to calculate volume, then you're going to take mass over density. Therefore, if I need kinetic energy over volume, kinetic energy over volume, this means that I take 1/2 mv² divided by the value of volume, and our volume here is m over rho. So this is the value of volume, mass over density. So kinetic energy over volume, you take kinetic energy 1/2 mv² over volume, which is mass over rho. Calculating the potential energy divided by volume, this will be mgh divided by m over rho. So I want to simplify this equation so that we have kinetic energy per unit volume and the potential energy per unit volume, so that at this point I'll have 1/2, and this will be equivalent to 1/2 mv² multiplied by rho over m. So if you divide a number by a fraction, then you multiply by its reciprocal, and here we are going to have mgh multiplied by rho over m. So that kinetic energy per unit volume is given by, our solution comes from here, I'll cancel m with m, so that I have 1/2 rho v² 1/2 rho v². At the same point, my potential energy per unit volume will be given by, at this point I'll cancel m with m, so that I remain with rho gh. So that this is the value of potential energy per unit volume, and this is the value of kinetic energy per unit volume. Therefore, I've come here and summarized the Bernoulli's principle. using what we call the Bernoulli's equation. So on the Bernoulli's equation, I said that the sum of pressure P plus the kinetic energy per unit volume, it's here. Kinetic energy per unit volume is rho gh plus the potential energy per unit volume is here, that is a half rho v squared. This one should be equivalent to a constant. So that the sum of pressure, kinetic energy per unit volume, and potential energy per unit volume is equivalent to a constant. So this equation here is known as the Bernoulli's equation. Therefore, when you state the Bernoulli's equation, it gives you the Bernoulli's principle. That the Bernoulli's principle states that the sum of pressure, kinetic energy per unit volume, and potential energy per unit volume is equivalent to a constant. Therefore, from deriving the equations here, that is from kinetic energy. What is kinetic energy? This is the energy which is possessed by the bodies in motion. It's calculated by a half mv squared. Potential energy is the energy possessed by the bodies at rest, which is calculated by mgh. To get to volume is equal to mass over density. So when I take kinetic energy, I divide it by volume. I take the equation of kinetic energy, which is half mv squared, it's here, divide it by volume. My volume here is mass over density, m over rho. Summarize this equation to get kinetic energy per unit volume to be a half rho v squared. Potential energy is given by mgh. Potential energy over volume is mgh divided by m over rho. This will give me rho gh as my potential energy per unit volume. So to summarize them using the Bernoulli's equation, then the sum of pressure plus potential energy per unit volume plus kinetic energy per unit volume is equivalent to a constant. So this summarizes everything about the Bernoulli's principle and the Bernoulli's effect. So most of the questions that is on the Bernoulli's principle and the Bernoulli's effect will revolve around around this region, which is going to give you a very easy task. So with me, I want to give you the assignment for the work. So that is the assignment that you're supposed to work out. Try and work out that assignment. If you can't find the answer, you can seek more consultation through the comments below. So thank you so much for being part of our lesson today. See you next time. The question you are doing is the question number 3. You can be able to see it there.